The following program is paid for by friends and partners of Apostle Guillermo Maldonado and King Jesus International Ministry.
On today's episode of The Supernatural Now.
If it's possible, tell him every day. The devil will tell you, yeah, but you missed it yesterday. But you cussed your wife yesterday. But you did this. You say, Jesus, with all the weaknesses and faults, I love you. I love you.
Jesus came to earth to teach and to demonstrate the supernatural with miracles, signs, and wonders. God doesn't change. God is supernatural. Apostle Guillermo Maldonado is called to bring God's supernatural power to this generation. For over 25 years, he has been teaching and activating believers from around the world to do the same. Get ready to receive your miracle today and allow God to use you to demonstrate his power here and now. This is a reality you can experience in your life today. Join us as we see more of the supernatural now.
God bless you. I'm Apostle Guillermo Maldonado, and I just want you to be prepared to receive a very powerful revelation on the commandment of love. What is love? Why God gives a commandment? When you go to the scriptures, you will see many things about love. But one of the things that God said, my love, Jesus said, is a commandment. Why God gives a commandment? Number one, because a commandment is not an option. In other words, so many people said, no, I don't feel to love this person. Love is not based on feeling. Love is not an option. You don't choose to love. In other words, God said, I'm going to give you love for you to love. And it's not an option. It's a commandment. It's a written law. In other words, and God, when God gives a commandment, also he gives it in a part of this, in basis of foresight. He sees the future. And he knows that the only thing that can work is a commandment. That's why he gives a commandment, because he knows the future. Don't try to do something else different than God. God said, I want you to choose to love. And I want you to see what a commandment is. And I want you to start now walking in the love of God. Let's watch. Let's go to the tabernacle and see this powerful message. A commandment doesn't have feelings. A commandment doesn't have feeling. I don't feel to love this man. It doesn't matter. It is written. I don't like him. It doesn't matter. It is written. I have to love him. I don't like her. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It is written. It is a law. God said it. It's done. And that you have to love. In other words, stop choosing who you're gonna love. You're gonna love because God said love, period. So it's a commandment. Command is something that is verbalized. It's a decree. Commandment, God said, whatever I decree, I want you to write it in a law. And this doesn't have any feeling. I don't feel it. Why God gives a commandment? So the Bible is full of his commandments.
God has never asked us to do something when he has not given us the grace to do it. Somebody said, you tell me I don't have any choose? I don't have any choice, option, who to love to? No. Pastor, do you mean to tell me I have to love everyone? Yes. I didn't say that you have to be intimate with everyone. I didn't say that, but you have to love them. Love your enemies. Love those that are rejected. Love those that are hard to love. There's some people in the church that are very hard to love. I said, Jesus, give me the grace. Give me double portion of love, because this guy, I'm going to hit him hard. But I want to love him. Touch your neighbor and tell him, I feel loving today. Come on, God said, feel loving. Okay, God never asks you anything if first has not given you the grace to do it. Romans chapter 5, verse 5. And the love of God has been poured down, another translation says, into your heart. So Romans 5, 5, pour out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Because the love of God, say it again, because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts. By who? By who? When the Holy Spirit, when you came to Jesus, you received Jesus, that moment the Holy Spirit came into you and the love of God came unto you. In other words, you don't have an excuse now to say, I don't have love. Because you already have it. Now, the question is, you haven't made the decision to love. Because already God gave you the grace to do it. Number two, we must have love before we give love. John, 1 John 4:19. We must have love before we give love. 1 John 4:19, you will see something very powerful. We love him, he loved us. We love him. Pastor, I love God so much. I don't brag about my love for God. I brag his love to me. Can I hear an amen? In other words, in the condition of being a sinner, we came to God and he loved us. So first, we love him because he loved us first. In other words, let's brag about his great love and being a sinner. And he loved us. So what are you saying? Number three. So God loved us first. That's why we love him now. So the supreme purpose of love is to love God first. Matthew 22:37. The supreme purpose of love is to love God first. Why? Because it's priority. And look at, say, Matthew chapter 22, verse 37. Then said Jesus said to them, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul and all your mind. The love of God, and this I'm going to finish in here. The love of God must be demonstrated. There's not such a thing. I love you. Wait a minute. Show me. Demonstrate me. 1 John 3:16 and 17. Any invisible truth has to become visible, invisible manifestation in the physical dimension. By this we know love, because he laid down his life for us, and we also ought to. Laid down. What do you mean laid down? You mean you live to help and serve other people. That's laid down your life. Love cannot be assumed, but must be expressed. You know I love you. Wait a minute. How you express to me that you love me with the words? That's nice. But I want to see the manifestation. When I need you, you there for me. When I need your support, you there for me. So what are you saying? And this is what most of the wives says to their husband. You haven't told me you love me. And the husband answers, you know I love you. What are they saying? They are assuming. And love never, never is assumed. Love must be expressed. How do you express love? Love is expressed through words, through physical hugs, kisses, giving yourself, giving time to the people, serving people. In other words, there's so many ways that you can express love. The church is lacking of love. Why? There's some people that come through, I need the pianist, come through those doors, and one of the ushers get close to the person, give them a hug. I have seen hundreds of people that when they came to me, I hugged them with the love of God. and they were instantly delivered. It's about time that the church not assume love, but demonstrate love. When somebody's at the hospital, did you call them? When somebody's sick, did you tell them, I'm there? Do you need anything? When somebody needs help with the family, are you saying, I'm here? Or you have a personal agenda? Peter said to Jesus, he betrayed Jesus. Judas also betrayed Jesus. But Judas did not repent. Why? Because he never forgave himself. What Peter did was worse. It was worse. But Judas committed suicide. The people that commit suicide is based on self-hatred. If you hate yourself, the next step is commit suicide. How come are you going to hate yourself when God loves you? He loves you so much. So Judas committed suicide because he hated himself. And he never repented. What Peter did was worse. 3 times. And he forgave himself. He forgave. He repented. What are you saying? Then he said, Jesus said, can you call Peter? Peter came. And Jesus got close to Peter. I gotta feel the presence of God. I feel the love of God. He said, Jesus. He said, Peter, how are you, son? Peter, I can see Peter. Shame of what he did. Shame. He said, Peter, do you love me? And Peter said, why is he asking me this? Why? After I betrayed him. Then he said, Lord, you know I love you. Then Jesus said, okay, Peter. He walked away a little bit, and then he came back. Say, Peter, do you love me, son? He said, so, Lord, you know I love you. Please don't torment me. I love you. And then he went back for the third time. He said, Peter, do you love me? And somebody said, why Jesus asked 3 times? 2 purposes. 1, Peter was being healed, confessing that he loved Jesus. When you say, I love you, Jesus, your heart is being healed. Pastor, but what it doesn't let me say, I love God, because I committed so many things and I've been wrong so many times and I've been stubborn and you don't understand. I missed it many times. What Peter did was worse. I said, Peter, do you love me, son? I said, you know I love you. And the second thing why Jesus asked is because he wants to hear from you that you love him. If it's possible, tell him every day. The devil will tell you, yeah, but you missed it yesterday. But you cussed your wife yesterday. But you did this. You say, Jesus, with all the weaknesses and faults, I love you. I love you. God is asking you today, do you love me? And you say, Jesus, but I fell yesterday. Jesus, but I don't know how come. The Bible says if you love him, you keep his commandments. You must accept the love of God. You must believe the love of God. You must receive the love of God. Because you were hurt in the past. Because you were hurt, you were offended. You don't believe the love of God. You must believe it. You must experience it. You must accept it. You must experience it. And today I'm going to ask, how many Peters can identify with Peters and say, Apostle, I believe my love walks cold. But I want a portion of the love of God. I want to know that he loves me. And I want to have that conviction that I love him. If you're one of those Peters that identified with Peters, I want you to stand for a moment. The Holy Spirit said to me, call the couples. Call the couples. All the couples. There's a new dimension of love coming on the couples. I want the husband to ask your wife for forgiveness. I want you to say to her, I'm sorry if I made you feel like you were nothing. I'm sorry if I offended you. God cannot bring a supernatural love if you're not forgive first. Go. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I release a new mantle of love upon the couple.
If you want a new baptism of love, I want you to lift your hands. I want to count to three. When I count to three, I want you to receive a new baptism of love. One, two, three. Now! New baptism of love. New baptism of love. New baptism of love. New baptism of love. Come on, take it.
Say, Father, right now, by the Holy Spirit, by the Holy Spirit, I receive your supernatural, unconditional love of God. Father, heal my heart. Heal my heart. Heal my wounds. Right now, I do have love to love you and love others. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I am baptized in the love of God. If you are the house, your wife or your husband, I want you to say, I love you. I express that love. Don't assume. Express it. Manifest it. Go with the kids, your children. Tell them, I love you, son. I love you, daughter. Do it in the house right now. Come on, do it in the house.
Stay tuned for supernatural testimonies.
Every time you testify, you are telling the devil, I overcame you. You need to testify. God has a testimony through you.
When I got married, I remember thinking that I really wanted my husband to fix all the areas in my life where I kind of felt broken. I was very insecure. I really didn't know what direction I wanted to go in or who I really was at that time. I think the lowest point in my life was after my divorce. It was really difficult. Coming to King Jesus Ministries, I have learned that our identity is found in Christ and in Him and only in Him.
I didn't have identity. I didn't know who I was as a woman, as a person. I had so much unforgiveness in my heart towards my dad, and being that God had a purpose for my life, I was always different, and I couldn't understand, God, why I don't fit in. I don't fit in with anybody. Mm-hmm. And not until recently did I understand that God separates His children, you know, He keeps us for a purpose. And I didn't understand what that purpose was, and I was walking around without knowing my purpose, without knowing my identity, walking around with unforgiveness towards in my heart, towards my father, towards people in my family, because they mistreated me. They always made me feel ostracized, like I wasn't good enough, I wasn't smart enough, I wasn't pretty enough. And I always felt like I was trying to prove something to people. And when I came to this church and I went to the deliverance retreat, God broke off so much unforgiveness off my heart. And then my daughter told me last year, I think I was driving her back to school, and she says, Mom, this person in my family sexually molested me. And the anger that welled up within me, the hurt, because I felt like I failed my child.
Now, I feel like I'm on a journey. Every day is newness with Him. Every day I learn more about myself, and every day I learn more about God and who He is to me, how much He loves me. He's teaching me how to be a better mom. He's teaching me how to be a better woman, a better daughter. He's teaching me so much, and I'm really thankful to know the love of God, to know the love of a father.
When I was at the age of one, my parents got divorced. So I grew up with my grandma, because my mom came over here to Miami. And while I was living with my grandma, at the age of five, starting five, six, I was molested by certain two people. So ever since I was around that young age, I was exposed to sexual, you know, things like lustful things, like sex, you know, masturbation, pornography, I was forced to do things that I didn't like. After like 7 or 8 again, I moved here with my mom and grandma. And then I started growing up. My mom met this man who is now my father, and he brought us to church. But at the same time, I didn't like it. So I started hanging out with the wrong people. I would be smoking, doing drugs. And then I would look for love in girls. Every time I would be with someone at the same time, like they would tell me they love me, but I would feel rejected deep inside of me. I doubt it always. Every time I would be in a relationship, I would doubt that they truly love me. So I was like, do you really love me? Do you really think I'm pretty? And I would always self-doubt myself of who I was. I had self-low esteem. And I don't know why, but something in me intrigued me to come to CGC 2013. And it really touched me in a way, you know, the way they were speaking. And then I was like, God, I surrender my life to you. And then when I'm in my room, I was like, you know what, God, you know I truly surrender my life to you. And somehow I just started singing to God. And then it was that moment, like I had never had an encounter like God. It started hitting me, I started crying, shaking, burning. It was something that I couldn't explain. I ran to my parents upstairs, and then I hugged them. We were all crying, though. You know, the love of God started falling and everything. And ever since that time, it has provoked me to seek more of God. It has impacted me so much that, you know, I don't want to go back to the same way I was. The love of God has filled me up so much. I don't hold anything against those people who hurt me in the past. You know, I dealt with resentment with my mom because she left me. But, you know, God has filled me up, and, you know, I've learned to forgive her. I learned to, like, let go of those offenses or what she did. You know, now I value my mom more. I love her. You know, I love my dad now that I have. But above all things, I love my father who is in the heavens and who is here with me right now.
To share your supernatural testimony, please write to us at 14100 Southwest 144th Avenue, Miami, Florida 33186, or email us at testimonies@kingjesusministry.org.
God bless you, my friend. I believe Jesus is the Christ and he loves you. Anytime you have a question, does God love me? Well, just go back to the cross. The cross is a sign. Every time you said, do I have any doubt that God loves me? Just let's go back to the cross. The cross is the sign that God loved you from the beginning. Before you were a sinner, before you were a Christian, God loves you. My friend, if you never received Jesus as your personal Savior, I'm going to ask you and lead you into a prayer. You're going through crisis. You feel lonely. You need the love of God. I want you to repeat this prayer with me. I'm going to lead you into this prayer, and you repeat out loud. Say with me, Father God, I recognize that I am a sinner. I repent of all my sins. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Lord. Amen and amen. God is love, but power is what he has. And many of you need the power of God to be to touch your body, to touch your mind. If you're sick in your body, if you're oppressed in your mind, if you're afflicted, I'm going to pray for you right now. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I rebuke every sickness, I rebuke every disease, and I command any oppression go in Jesus' name. Any sickness, there's back condition being healed in Jesus' name. Ears are being opened. Surgery, there's somebody's surgery. You just had a surgery. God is healing your body right now. Knees are being replaced now, new knees. In Jesus' name, be healed, be delivered. Amen. And amen. If you did this prayer with me, thank you very much. If you received your healing, thank you very much. And what about if I remind you why believe in Jesus? This is a book that will touch your life. And if you receive Jesus for the first time, you need to know and read this book. And if you're watching one of my partners and saying, I want to support you sending that book to other people that don't know Jesus, for a seed of any amount, I can send it to you right now free. God bless you. I love you. See you next time.
Are you looking for the truth? What is the truth? Many of us seek something real for our lives. We wonder if it is possible to have peace, purpose, and empowerment in a world that seems to be falling apart with each passing day.
Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Yet who is this Jesus? And if he truly was the Savior, in what way does that reality affect us today? And why should we believe in him?
All my life, I was searching for answers, and the only answer is Jesus.
I was a Muslim. Thank God things have changed. Jesus is the truth.
I was empty. I want to know the truth.
Only Jesus Christ, and he set me free.
And I wanted something real.
I am free because Jesus is Lord.
3 million gods in India, but nobody took Jesus Lord, healed my wife from cancer.
In this book, you will find the meaning behind the life and teachings of Jesus Christ and learn how his existence connects with your purpose. Now is the time for you to discover the answer to the question, why believe in Jesus? Get ready to experience God's supernatural power and to go above and beyond in 2015. Make plans now and join us in our upcoming main events to enter into a new level and walk in a greater dimension of the supernatural power of God. June 24th through the 27th, Supernatural Fivefold Ministry School, Module 11. Chosen Generation Youth Conference, CGC 2015. October 8th through the 10th, Apostolic and Prophetic Conference, CAP 2015. These are not just events. This is a movement of the glory of God you cannot miss. Your life, family, ministry, and business will never be the same. Register today. For more information, visit kingjesusministry.org/events.
Thank you for watching today's program. If you want to learn more on how to accelerate and enable you to experience the supernatural in your life, contact us today. Join us next time as we see more of the supernatural now.
The previous program was paid for by the friends and partners of Apostle Guillermo Maldonado and King Jesus International Ministry.